Hey YouTubers! So this video kind of consists of all Easter, spring, DIY decors, because I really feel like I haven't done a DIY in like forever, since like Valentine's Day, and that is unacceptable. I'm going to show you some really cute DIYs of stuff that you don't have to run to the store and buy if you want to decorate for Easter, and they don't even have to stay up just for Easter. It's very spring-like and you can have it through the spring season. So instead of buying some decorations to spring up your house, spring up, is that a phrase or did I just make that up? Instead of buying some decorations, you can just make some yourself because they're cheaper and more fun that way. Did I mention I'm making treats? Like I'm making like the cutest egg-shaped treats you'll ever see. And give this video a thumbs up if you love spring because no more winter. Winter's out the window. We're forgetting all about winter. It is spring, so give a thumbs up if you are so ready for spring and cute tops and no jackets. So let's cut the chit chat and get the DIY started.
So to start this DIY, the first thing you're gonna need are some colorful strings, a whole lot of Elmer's glue, and a few balloons. Next, you're gonna start blowing the balloons. I chose water balloons because I wanna make smaller eggs. If you wanna make bigger eggs, then I would use a bigger balloon. Next, get a small bowl and pour all your glue in there because trust me, you're gonna need every drop. Next, start cutting your string, then soak it in the glue. After that, wrap it around your balloon. Remember, there is no right or wrong way to do this. It is very abstract looking egg. Just make sure it keeps into an egg shape form. And after repeating this process about a dozen times, you gotta hang it someplace so it can dry overnight. I chose the shower rod because why not? Except Kirby totally thought it was her new jungle gym and I had to lock her out the bathroom. The next day when everything is dry, just push on the balloon a little bit to loosen it from the strings, then pop it with a needle. When you're done cleaning out your abstract eggs, it's time to put them on a string and hang them up. All I wanna do is lose control, and that's why I smile. It's been a while since every day and everything has felt this right. And now. So first, of course, you're gonna make Rice Krispies the way you will always make Rice Krispies. So next you're going to take your egg molds and spray them with Pam. Then it's helpful if you spray your hands with Pam too, so that way your Rice Krispies don't get stuck to your hands. Then proceed to decorate your eggs however you want. You, where the hell did you come from? You're a different, different kind of fun. And I'm so used to feeling numb. Now, I've got pins and first, to start making my dandelions, I took a stick and just painted it green for the stem. Then I took a stack of yellow tissue paper and made a really big square. And remember, you need both sides to the dandelion, so you need to do this process twice. Once I cut my squares, I folded it so I can staple the middle of the square so that way all the papers would stick together. Then I trimmed it into a circle. Next, I cut strips into the rim of the circle so when I scrunch it together, it gives it some texture. Now for the super easy part, squishing paper together. And when you have your two big yellow pom-poms, just grab some glue, put your stick in the middle, and glue everything, and you're done. Now you need a decorative vase to put your flowers in. So I got this flower from IKEA, and then I grabbed a bunch of Easter-themed snacks. You know, things that you will always think to eat around Easter, like marshmallows and jelly beans and Peeps. You know you can't forget the Peeps. Then I topped it off with some colorful grass, stuck some other fake flowers in with my dandelions, and my centerpiece was done.
So if you could check out my other YouTube channel, I have a link down below. So thumbs up channel, not a thumbs down, that is pointing at my channel.